Ya, pero no jugó, todo el mundo con él.
Sí, pero así alguien y quiso la pelea en YouTube con Bolívar. ¿Por qué día de la época?
Exactamente. No tenía algo.
Tú viso, Sara y Polizuales de este. So let's start today's class. So yesterday we talked about few concepts, income tax. We talked about resident, non-resident, who are resident, who are not resident. Only for resident, Indian income is taxable. Now we'll talk about exemptions. That I told you one thing in the starting, that in income tax, how the tax will be calculated. So firstly, your all incomes will be calculated under five heads. Then certain deductions are allowed under few rules. And then the net income will be charged to tax as per the rates. The rates are prescribed in Finance Act. So what exactly is to be done? The income should be calculated under five heads. So this income, which should be calculated under five heads, there are certain exemptions, because not every income is taxable. There are certain incomes which are not taxable. Government do not tax certain incomes. So what all are those incomes which government do not tax? There are five heads we talked: salary, house property, business profession, capital gain, and other source. So first we will talk about salary. So what all incomes are exempted under the head salary? Because the whole salary is not taxable. If you are getting a salary of 1 lakh per month, it's 12 lakh. You need not pay tax on entire 12 lakh. There are some exemptions available. So let's study about those exemptions. The first exemption that we can talk about is that you will get an exemption limit of 2.5 lakh. So 2.5 lakh, 2,50,000 exemption is available to everybody. To everybody, whoever is paying the tax. So basic exemption limit is available. It's not just about salary. Any income if you have, you will get a basic exemption limit for everyone. That is 2.5 lakh. It is for normal. If you are a senior citizen, the limit is 3 lakh. If you are a super senior citizen, that is above the age of 80, then the limit is 5 lakh. Then I told you, after calculation of all five heads, deductions will be allowed, and after deductions, basic exemption limit will be allowed. So we are going reversely. So basic exemption limit will be available to everyone. That is again after deduction, and deduction is available to everyone, from all the incomes. So what all are the general deductions? ATC. What is ATC? 1.5 lakh. So ATC is like provident fund, public provident fund, life insurance premium, house loan repayment, national security certificate, 5-year FDR, senior citizen savings scheme. So these are deductions under ATC, that is 1.5 lakh. So this is available again to all the heads. So this is common for all the heads, basic exemption and deduction. Now, specific exemption from salary is number one, HRA. So HRA will be exempt. Suppose anyone is receiving HRA in his salary, the salary has HRA amount, then you can claim exemption from HRA. Not, you cannot, government do not want to charge tax on entire HRA. What they want, you claim exemption lower of the following: 40% of your basic salary plus DA. So 40% of basic plus DA you can claim as exempt from the HRA, and it is 50% in case of Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai, that is metro cities. So in the metro cities, 50% of the basic plus DA is exempt as HRA. Second is rent paid minus 10% of basic plus DA. Actual HRA received. So lower of the following will be exempt. You need to calculate all the three things. Whatever is the minimum will be exempt. Exempt means there will be no tax on this amount. If there are any questions, you can ask. Gratuity. If your salary has gratuity received, then you can claim exemption. So how much you can claim? 15 days salary for every completed years of service. So what is gratuity? Let us understand that. And before that, let me also explain you what is HRA. House rent allowance. An allowance which is given for you're living in a rented house. You're living in a rented house. Your employer says, I'll give you house rent allowance so that you can pay your rent. So if you are paying your rent, this much you can claim exempt, because how can you be forced to pay the tax which you're not even earning? Because whatever rent allowance you're receiving, you're paying the same to your landlord. So government is giving you exemption. Okay, if you have really paid the rent, we will give you exemption. Now for gratuity, what is gratuity? So gratuity is a gratitude payment. Suppose you have worked with an employer for 5 years or for 10 years and you are leaving that organization. Then the government, then the employer is very grateful to you that, oh, I'm very grateful that you have worked with me for so many years. I want to pay some good amount to you as gratuity. So gratuity is gratitude payment. So for so many years of your good service, you might get a gratuity from your employer when you leave the organization. So you can claim exemption from that also. How much? 15 days salary for every completed year of service. Suppose you have worked for 5 years, your salary is 1 lakh. What is 15 days salary? 50,000. Because you are earning 1 lakh per month and your 15 days salary will be 50,000 for every completed year of service. How many years completed? 5. So 15,000 multiplied by 5. 50,000 multiplied by 5. That is 2,50,000 will be exempt. But lower of the following, 20 lakh or 20 lakh, whichever is lower, will be exempt. Not be taxable. For government employee, gratuity is fully exempt. You may receive 1 crore, it's exempt because you are a government employee. Commutation of pension. sometimes some employees, because every government employee receives a pension and many private employees also receives pension. So if you are receiving a pension, but you want to commute it, what is commutation? Commutation is accumulation. It's like, I don't want a pension every month. Give me now. So that is known as commutation of pension. You don't want to receive the pension every month. You just want to receive the whole year's pension amount now itself, where on the date of retirement. So that is known as commutation of pension. So if you receive a commutation pension and you also receive a gratuity, then 1/3 of total commuted pension is exempt. Not receive a gratuity, half of the total commutation of pension is exempt. Leave encashment. Okay, give me 1 minute. In the case of leave encashment, if it is received during service, so what is leave encashment? Suppose you get 15 days leave in a year, but you took just two or three leaves. Remaining leaves are in your credit. So many employers give an option that you can get cash in lieu of leaves. So maybe 12 leaves if you have free, then you can get 12 leaves salary in spite of taking a leave. So if you took 12 days salary as a cash, that is known as leave encashment. So if you are receiving it during service, it is fully taxable. If you receive at the time of retirement, in case of government employee, it is fully exempt. In case of non-government employee, lower of the following will be exempt. So leave encashment actually received, 10 months of average salary or unavailed leaves multiplied by average salary or rupees 3 lakh, whichever is lower. Now, leave travel concession. So what is leave travel concession? Many employers gives a compulsory leave or a fixed leave. You take a leave, you go and travel in the country. You go with your family, you enjoy. For that purpose, they give you 1 lakh rupees, 2 lakh rupees. Just take this money and go out and just enjoy, chill with your family so that your mind will get cold, your mind will get stress-free and you will work with more efficiency. So that's the purpose of leave travel concession or leave travel assistance. Actual expenses that you incur on travel will be exempt. So suppose you get some amount from your employer for traveling in the country or maybe out of the country, whatever actual expenses of rail fare or air fare will be the exemption. So suppose you incurred 2 lakh rupees on the air fare, but you received 3 lakh rupees from your employer, only 2 lakh will be exempt. Voluntary retirement benefits, up to rupees 5 lakh it is exempt. Medical treatment, if you do medical treatment for your or your own family, up to 25,000 it is exempt. Dependent parents, up to 25,000, again more is exempt. If any one of you or your family or your parents are senior citizen, then 50,000 will be the limit in each above. If you do the treatment in out of the country, as per the limits set by Reserve Bank of India, will be the exemption amount. If you get a treatment in government or approved hospital and you get a reimbursement from your employer for that, it is fully exempt without any limits. Gift, if you receive a gift from your employers, up to 5,000 in a year is exempt. If you are paying any professional tax to your state government, it is fully exempt. If you receive an entertainment allowance, up to 5,000 is exempt in case of government employee only. In case of non-government employee, you cannot entertain yourself because entertainment allowance is exempt only in case of government employee. Conveyance or transport allowance for cost of travel. Suppose your employer sent you Delhi, sent you Bombay for some work. You incurred train expenses or fare expenses, any travel expenses for the traveling purposes. As per actual whatever you are, and the employer gives you that amount, then it is exempt. Obviously, it's not your income. Refreshment during office hours. Suppose you get a tea during office hours, there will be no tax on the tea. Suppose you get recreational facilities, like you can play some carom, something in your office during your lunchtime, then there is no tax on that. You get a vehicle from your home to office for coming office, it is exempt. So these are the exemptions from salary. So these exemptions are from salary. Similarly, all other heads also have exemptions. So if there are any questions, please let me know. I'm here till 6 p.m.